Good morning, students. In the last session, we have started crop production and management. So today we will be continuing the same lesson. So here I am going to explain one activity. So what is the activity? Let us see. Take a beaker and fill half of it with water. Put a handful of wheat seeds and stir well. Wait for some time. So you have to take one beaker. Half of this beaker you can fill with water and you can put some seeds. What seeds you're going to put? Wheat seeds and stir well. Okay, so what you can observe, are the seeds which float on water, would those be lighter or heavier than those which sink? Why would they be lighter? Damaged seeds become hollow and are thus lighter, therefore they float on water. So you would have studied that if any substance when you put into water, some it will sink, some substances they can float in water, it based on the density. If it is more denser, it will go down. If it is a less denser than water, they can float on water. Same like here, you can see some seeds, it will go down. You can see here, but some seeds, it will float on water. So what is the reason this? Because it is very lightweight. Why it is lightweight? Because it is damaged seeds. Okay. So these damaged seeds become hollow and are thus lighter. That is the reason, therefore, they float on water. So sowing. Traditional tool. The tool used for traditionally for sowing seeds is shaped like a funnel. The seeds are filled into the funnel, passed down through two or three pipes having sharp ends. These ends pierce into the soil and place seeds there. Okay, you can look at the figure. You can see that there is some funnel shape. In this funnel, they will be filling the seeds. And you can see that down there is a pipe from here. Again, one or two pipes, it will be there. But one end of the end of the pipe, it will be like little sharp. So what with that sharp end, what they can do, these ends pierce into the soil and place seeds there. Okay, that is the traditional tool. Clear. So the tool used traditionally for sowing seed is shaped like a funnel. The seeds are filled into the funnel, passed down through two or three pipes having sharp ends. These ends pierce into the soil and place seeds there. Clear. The next seed drill, but nowadays the seed drill is used for sowing with the help of tractors. So this is a seed drill. It is fixed to or connected with these tractors. This tool sows the seeds uniformly at proper distances and depths. It ensures that seeds get covered by the soil after sowing. This prevents damage caused by birds. Sowing by using a seed drill saves time and labor. Okay, so these are the advantages. So what are the, this is a seed drill. So here they'll be keeping the seeds. You can see that it will fall in equal distance. Okay, uniformly at proper distances and depth. It ensures that the seeds get covered by the soil after sowing. And also what are the advantage? This prevents damage caused by the birds, and also sowing by using a seed drill, it saves time and labor. We can save the time and also labor. These are the advantages. Then adding manure and fertilizers. I saw a, here you can see, Paheli and Bujo here. Paheli saying, I saw a healthy crop growing in a farm. In the neighboring farm, the plants are weak. Why do some plants grow better than others? So we're going to find the answer for this question. The substances which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients for the healthy growth of plants are called manure, or actually they are called manures. Fertilizers also we are using, but this fertilizers, it is man-made. It is making in factories. Okay, so soil manure and fertilizers supplies mineral nutrients to the crop. These nutrients are essential for the growth of plants. Continuous growing of crops makes the soil poorer in certain nutrients. So why we are adding manure or fertilizer? Manure means all this compost. It's a natural manure. Compost or cow dung, all these are manures. Okay, but the fertilizer means it is man-made. We are making in the factories, but we will use for the plant the fertilizers. Plant will grow very well, but at the same time, after some time, what will happen? The soil, it will lose its fertility. Okay, so the substances which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients for the healthy growth of plants, they are called what? They are called manures, and also we will call fertilizers. Soil manure and fertilizer supplies mineral nutrients to the crop. These nutrients are essential for the growth of plant. Continuous growing of crops makes the soil poorer in certain nutrients. Okay. Then adding manure and fertilizers. Therefore, farmers have to add manure to the field to replenish the soil with nutrients. This process is called manuring. So what is meant by manuring? The farmers, they add manure to the field to replenish the soil with the nutrients. This process is called manuring. Improper or insufficient manuring results in weak plants. Okay, if you are not giving the manure properly, the plant will be weak. Improper or insufficient manuring results in weak plants. Okay. Then, what are fertilizers? Fertilizers are chemical substances which are rich in a particular nutrient. Fertilizers are produced in factories. The use of fertilizers has helped the farmers to get better yield of crops such as wheat, paddy, maize. I told fertilizers, it's a man-made we are making in the factories. It's very good for plant. Plant can grow very well. But after I told after some time, what will happen if you are continuous, if you are using this fertilizer, it loses the fertility of the soil. Clear? So fertilizers are chemical substances which are rich in a particular nutrient. They are produced in factories. The use of fertilizers has helped farmers to get better yield of crops such as wheat, paddy, maize, etc. But what will happen? But excessive use of fertilizers has made the soil less fertile. Fertilizers have also become a source of water pollution. So these are the two disadvantages. When we put the fertilizer for the plant will grow very well. But continuous, if you are putting the fertilizer in the same soil, what you can see, the soil will become less fertile. Okay, after some time. And also these fertilizers, when the rain comes, along with this rainwater, it will flow, it will reach in the rivers or lakes, any water bodies, it causes water pollution. So fertilizers have also become a source of water pollution. So these are the two disadvantages of fertilizers. Okay, it makes the soil less fertile and also it makes water pollution. The next, what are the advantages of manure? The organic manure is considered better than fertilizers. This is because it enhances the water holding capacity of the soil. Second, it makes the soil porous, due to which exchange of gases becomes easy. Okay, so the manure means, you know, this compost or cow dung, all these are called manures. So what are the advantages of manures? It enhances the water holding capacity of the soil. One point, water holding capacity of the soil, because plants, they need water to grow. Second, it makes the soil porous. Porous means hole, okay, pores. It makes the soil porous, due to which exchange of gases becomes easy. Plants also need air, aeration they need. So it makes the soil porous, due to which exchange of gases becomes easy. These are the advantages. Again, it increases the number of friendly microbes. So when you are adding this manure like compost or cow dung, it increases the number of friendly microbes. You know which are the friendly microbes? The microbes which helps for the growth of the plant or earthworms. It makes the soil very loose and other bacteria, some other microbes will grow. It makes the soil very fertile. Okay, it is very good nutrient. It's good for the plant. So it increases the number of friendly microbes. It improves the texture of the soil and also it improves the texture of the soil. The activity, take moong or gram seeds and germinate them. Select three equal sized seedlings out of this. Now take three empty glasses or similar vessels. Make them ABC. To glass A, add little amount of soil mixed with a little cow dung manure. In glass B, put the same amount of soil mixed with a little urea. Take the same amount of soil in glass C without adding anything. Now pour the same amount of water in each glass and plant the seedlings in them. Keep them in a safe place and water them daily. After 7 to 10 days, observe their growth. So what you have taken? You have taken three glasses A, B, C. In glass A, what you will be adding? You will be adding a little amount of soil. That soil mixed with cow dung. Cow dung means it's a manure. Okay, it is organic manure, natural. Cow dung manure. In glass B, some amount of soil mixed with little urea. It's a fertilizer. Take some amount of soil in glass C without adding anything. Now pour the same amount of water in each glass and plant the seedlings in them. Keep them in a safe place and water them daily. After 7 to 10 days, observe their growth. So what you can see? Yes. Observe and answer. Did all the plants in all the glasses grow at the same place? Which glass showed better growth of plants? In which glass was the growth fastest? Okay, so that is a question. So you can see that the glass which did not add anything, it will grow little slow. But the second one, cow dung, that will grow better than the sea glass. But the fertilizer urea, it's a chemical fertilizer. It gives actually the fast growth. So did all the plants in all the glasses grow at the same place? Which glass showed the better growth of plants? So usually the fertilizers, it gives very good growth. Okay, but I told at the same time they are chemicals. It's not good. If you are using a long time, it is not good. Then just below that you can see that there is B. Then A glass, you can see cow dung. That is also will grow, but it will be little slower than fertilizer. But the C glass, you are not adding anything, it will be very slow growth. Which glass showed better growth of plants? In which glass was the growth fastest? Okay. The next one is, what are the differences between fertilizer and manure? Fertilizer means it is an inorganic salt. Here, manure is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of cattle dung, human waste, and plant residues, etc. Second difference, fertilizer is prepared in factories. Here, manure can be prepared in the fields. Third difference, a fertilizer does not provide any humus to the soil. Excuse me. But the manure provides a lot of humus to the soil. Fourth difference, fertilizers are very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Manure is relatively less rich in plant nutrients. So these are the main differences between fertilizer and manure. I'll repeat. One is inorganic salt. Here, it is a natural substance obtained by the decomposition of cattle dung, human waste, and plant residues, etc. Second difference, it is prepared in factories. Here, this is prepared in fields. Okay, one is in factory, one is in field. Here, fertilizer does not provide any humus to the soil. Fertilizer does not provide any humus. Here, manure provides a lot of humus to the soil. Clear. It does not provide any humus, but this provides humus to the soil. Fertilizer is very rich in plant nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. Manure is relatively less rich in plant nutrients. Clear. So these are the differences between fertilizer and manure. The next one is irrigation. What is meant by irrigation? All living beings need water to live. Water is important for proper growth and development of flowers, fruits, and seeds of plants. Water is absorbed by the plant roots. Along with water, minerals and fertilizers are also absorbed. Plants contain nearly 90% water. Water is essential because germination of seeds does not take place under dry conditions. Okay, so water is very essential for the growth of the plants, and also at the same time, germination will not take place without water. So when you, after the sowing the seed, you have to give the water. That is called irrigation. You have to pour the water for the plant. That is called irrigation. Otherwise, germination will not take place. Okay, children. So all living beings need water to live. Water is very important for proper growth and development of flowers, fruits, and seeds of plant. Water is absorbed by the roots. Along with water, it also will take minerals and fertilizers also absorbed. Plants contain nearly 90% water. It is essential because germination of seeds does not take place under dry conditions. They need water to germinate. Okay, then you can look at this irrigation. The supply of water to crops at different intervals is called irrigation. So what is meant by irrigation? The supply of water to crops at different intervals is called irrigation. The time and frequency of irrigation varies from crop to crop, soil to soil, and season to season. So it will not be the same every time. It depends upon mainly the time when we have to irrigate the plant or give the water, or what frequency, how much water we should give. It depends upon three things. One is crop to crop, it will be different, and also soil to soil. Some soil will be very dry soil, some will be a little moist soil. So it also depends upon the soil, to varies from soil to soil and season to season. Okay, suppose a rainy season, they don't want much water, but summer means they need more water. Okay, so it differentiate crop to crop, soil to soil, and season to season. Then, what are the sources of irrigation? The sources of irrigation are wells, tube wells, pond, lakes, rivers, dams, and canals. Okay, so which are the sources? Wells, tube wells, ponds, lakes, rivers, dams, and canals. The traditional methods of irrigation. What was the traditional method? The water available in wells, lakes, and canals is lifted up by different methods in different regions for taking it to the fields. Cattle or human labor is used in this method. In sometime in the olden days, they were using cattle or human labor is used in this method. So these methods are cheaper but less efficient. The various traditional ways are moat or pulley system. Second one is chain pump. These are different methods. One is moat or pulley system. Second, chain pump. Yes, traditional methods of irrigation. Pumps are commonly used for lifting water. Diesel, biogas, electricity, and solar energy is used to run these pumps. Okay, we will use pump or motor. We will call motor or pumps. They are commonly used for lifting water. This motor, what they will use, these pumps, what they will use? They use diesel, biogas, electricity, and solar energy is used to run these pumps. Modern methods of irrigation, sprinkler system. This system is more useful on the uneven land where sufficient water is not available. That is called sprinkler system. It is mainly more useful on the uneven land where sufficient water is not available. What is the sprinkler system? The perpendicular pipes, you can see here, perpendicular pipes having rotating nozzles on top are joined to the main pipeline at regular intervals. When water is allowed to flow through the main pipe under pressure with the help of a pump. Okay, so you can see that here, you can see there is one main pipe. In the regular intervals, you can see the pipes fixed here. There's a tip of this pipe. There you can see one rotating nozzles. So first the water is going through these pipes. That pressure, this nozzle, it will rotate. Okay, when it rotates, it will sprinkle everywhere. So the perpendicular pipes having rotating nozzles on top are joined to the main pipeline at irregular intervals. When water is allowed to flow through the main pipe under pressure with the help of a pump. The next method is called a drip system. It's also a modern method of irrigation. In this system, water falls drop by drop just at the position of the roots, near the roots. So it is called drip system. It is the best technique for watering fruit plants, gardens, and trees. Okay, so that is called a drip irrigation. So in this system, the water falls drop by drop near the roots, at the position of the roots. So it is called drip system. It is the best technique for watering fruit plants, gardens, and trees. Thank you, students.